Now, Islamic State militants have released another video showing the beheading of an American journalist. The group warns that another hostage will suffer the same fate unless the United States stops launching airstrikes in Iraq. Our Hwang Sung-hee has our top story.
It's titled, A Second Message to America. And it's a message that's just as brutal as the first. The video shows another American hostage, dressed in an orange jumpsuit, on his knees next to a masked man dressed in black and holding a knife. The beheading of U.S. journalist Steven Sotloff was posted online Tuesday by the Islamic State, with a warning to President Obama to halt airstrikes in Iraq.
So just as your missiles continue to strike our people, our knife will continue to strike the next of your people.
The masked man's voice is the same, an apparently British voice, as the world heard on the video of James Foley's murder a fortnight ago. Mr. Sotloff, a 31-year-old freelance journalist from Miami, disappeared while reporting from Syria in August last year, but his family had kept the news secret, fearing harm to him if they went public. Last week, Mr. Sotloff's mother issued a video appeal, pleading with the militants to spare her son.
As a mother, I ask your justice to be merciful and not punish my son for matters he has no control over.
In an effort to help battle Islamic State, President Obama announced Tuesday he will send around 350 additional military personnel to Iraq to protect U.S. diplomatic facilities and workers in Baghdad. The masked man in the latest video also shows who he claims to be a British national, identified on screen as David Haynes, and makes it clear he is also now at risk. Hwang Sung-hee, Arirang News.